episode starts with a man during ancient times coming in and trying to take a sundial. A woman comes in and tells him that he belongs to her. She then bites him on the neck and talks to the dial.
You cannot run. You belong to me, my love. For now. Forever. You're my eternal husband.
Back in modern times, Nigel's worried about Claudia, who is staring into space. She explains that she had a weird dream about being surrounded by vampires. Claudia explains that she woke up with a hickey, but it was eventually found out that she went to a rave the night before and just didn't remember it. Sydney walks in asking Claudia what she found out about vampires as she asks her to look up the history of female vampires, as a friend of hers, who's an author, is convinced that his girlfriend is one of them and is trying to kill him. The research Nigel has talks about how LeMay was a female vampire who had an affair with Zeus. Her descendants seduce men into relationships, eventually draining them of life until they die. You can place your own marriage jokes right here. The only way to stop LeMay is with an ancient sundial. Sydney shows Nigel a picture of her friend Eric's girlfriend Suzanne, who happens to be wearing a pendant that is the sign of LeMay, and she tells him how he's never been sick in his life, but now he's been in the hospital for a month. In Brussels, Nigel and Sydney go to the hospital to visit Eric, but they're stopped by a distraught Suzanne, who tells her that he's disappeared and she's worried about him. Sydney says she has an idea where to find him. She finds Eric at a bar he used to frequent, and he explains that he's positive she's the reason he's dying. He explains that she belongs to a female artist group, that he believes that the group is a cover-up for a vampire coven, and that when he went there, he saw the sundial, but that was the point that he started getting sick. Putting two and two together, he believes she realized he was going to steal the dial and began draining him. Sydney convinces him to go back to the hospital, but on the way out, Nigel makes eye contact with an attractive woman who was wearing a necklace of the LeMay. As Sydney gets Eric back to the bed, Suzanne gets very possessive and jealous, and they have a talk outside. Nigel, trying to get food out of a vending machine, makes eye contact with the attractive woman from before. This time, she's dressed as a nurse. We then see her go in Eric's room and leave a mark on his forehead. Sydney and Nigel head to the art group's headquarters and find that it is guarded by two women in cloaks. They climb the gate and head inside, just to see a group of women in cloaks that includes Suzanne doing some type of ritual with the sundial. The group is headed by the woman from the opening scene. Sydney tells Nigel to run, but instead he makes eye contact with the attractive woman from earlier. He goes into a trance and walks toward her, and they take him inside. Back at the hospital, Sydney explains to Eric what happened and tells him that she would have went inside, but she didn't know the layout. He tells her it's a historic building, so the layout is public record. That's when Suzanne storms in, having another jealous fit, accusing Sydney of being in love with him. That night, Sydney heads back to the estate, dressed similarly to the women there to blend in. She overhears them talking about where they've stored Nigel, and that the woman who has claimed him is named Anna. After they leave, she goes to save him. She convinces him to help her steal the sundial, which he reluctantly agrees to, though is clearly scared of the women. They find a secret passageway behind a painting that leads to a tomb containing crypts with women's names on them all, containing dead bodies of men. They notice the one with Suzanne's name is empty, and they realize that each one contains the men the women named on them killed, and the empty one is for Eric. They then infiltrate another ceremony. After a fight scene with the girls, the head vampire Emmanuel tells Sydney that she's been waiting a long time for her. Nigel, who ran off, runs into Anna, who once again seduces him into her room. Sydney, who is now tied up, is told by Emmanuel that she has a power and will be a great teacher for the Order, but Sydney responds with sarcasm. We find out that Suzanne is actually killing Eric, but she doesn't realize she's doing it, and she will not be fully initiated until after he dies, which she overhears and is freaked out about. Emmanuel tries to convince Sydney that it's not that bad for their victims, as they're basically sexed to death and die happy, and then forces her to drink something that knocks her out. Back in Anna's room, she continues to seduce Nigel, explaining to him that he belongs to her, and he gives in, and honestly, I can't really blame him. Meanwhile, Sydney is set up on a giant LeMay symbol, and they plan on doing a ritual with her in the sundial. Sydney escapes, and Suzanne helps her gain a weapon. Another fight scene ensues, where Sydney makes short work of an entire room of women by herself. This leaves her and Emmanuel and Suzanne as the last one standing. She tells Sydney this is proof that she is the right one, and after another sarcastic quip from Sydney, Emmanuel attempts to bite her, but is impaled by a sword and killed.
We are forever.
Nothing is forever. Seinfeld, perfect example. Give me that sundial! No!
Forever!
Sydney and Suzanne head to Anna's room to save Nigel. She eventually has to knock both her and Anna out and carry Nigel out, as he otherwise refused to leave and she wouldn't let him. They get back to the hospital and save Eric at the nick of time, using the sundial and the Tinkerbell method of thinking happy, happy thoughts. The show ends with Claudia revealing that she is goth now to impress a guy, but then she gets a call that he's now gone religious and now she needs to exchange her goth clothes for religious ones. Speaking of Claudia, on this show, she's played by Lindy Booth. If you want to see her with fangs, Lindy played an alien vampire cheerleader hybrid in the not very good 1998 film Teenage Space Vampires.
Let's bring the girl. Her brother's giving us trouble.
What's the little dweeb done this time?
Thanks for watching. If you like this content, please leave a like and subscribe and hit the bell icon to know every time I update. If you want to help my channel grow, please check out my Patreon, where you can get access to content early, as well as see the content that can't be uploaded here on YouTube. Link will be in the description. Until next time.